हेलो गाइज, आई एम फ्रॉम गौग्रास मैथ हब। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन क्वेश्चन दैट हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम चैप्टर 3 मैट्रिक्स एनसीईआरटी 12th मैथमेटिक्स। दैट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 20 एक्सरसाइज 3.2 = द बुक्स ऑफ ए पार्टिकुलर स्कूल हैज 10 dozen केमिस्ट्री बुक्स कामा 8 dozen फिजिक्स बुक्स कामा 10 dozen इकोनॉमिक्स बुक्स फ्लिप्टर। दियर सेलिंग प्राइसेस आर ₹80 कामा ₹60 एंड ₹40 ईच सब्जेक्ट रिस्पेक्टिवली फ्लिप्टर। फाइंड द टोटल अमाउंट of the book shop which receive from selling the books using matrix algebra. Now come out to solution equal to here you can see the book shop has 10 dozen chemistry books, 10 dozen chemistry books, 8 dozen physics books, 10 dozen economics books. Their prices are ₹80, ₹60, ₹40 each subject respectively. Find the total amount of the books up will receive from selling the books using matrix algebra. Now, here I shall write the things given in the question itself. I am going to reflect in the solution itself. Here you can see 10 dozen chemistry books. So here I shall write 10 dozen, given that, right here, given that, given that 10 dozen chemistry books, 10 dozen chemistry books, given that 10 dozen chemistry books, comma, 8 dozen physics books, 10 dozen economics books. This means that implied that here you can write implied that total number of chemistry books equal to total number of chemistry books equal to, here you can see 1 dozen equal to 12 quantity, 10 dozen equal to 120 quantity. So here it will become 120 because 10 will multiply to 12, it will become 120. 1 dozen equal to 12 quantity, then 10 dozen equal to 120 quantity means 120 chemistry books. Here it will become implied that 8 dozen physics books, here The scale is that 1 dozen. 1 dozen equal to 12 quantity. Then 8 dozen equal to 8 into 12. It will become 12 at the 96. So here I shall write total number of physics book equal to 12 into 8, it will become 96. And here you will get total number of economics books equal to 1 dozen equal to 12 quantity, 10 dozen equal to 120, it will become. So here you have got total number of chemistry books equal to 120, total number of physics books equal to 96, total number of economics books equal to 120. So here you can see total number 120, total number 96, total number 120. These 120, 96 and 120 are like terms. Therefore, 120, 96 and 120 will be grouped together. So here I shall write, since 120, 96 and 120 are like terms, hence must be grouped together. Respectively, I shall do the grouping of chemistry books, physics books, and economic books. Grouped together, here you can say write further respectively. Respectively means first here it is given chemistry books, the 120 will be chemistry books. Here you can see at second position the number of physics book will be 96, and here at third position the number of economics books will be 120. Therefore 120, 96 and 120 are like terms, hence must be grouped together. Now again you can see here you can see the cost of one chemistry book is 80. So here I shall write, since this is a sign of since here you can see each subject respectively means here you can see rupees 80 is meant for chemistry books are there at first position. Therefore, rupees 80 is also at the first position. Therefore, each subject means chemistry subject. One chemistry book will cost rupees 80. So here I shall write one chemistry book costs rupees 80. Therefore, how many chemistry books are there? There are 120 chemistry books. here you can write 120 chemistry books cost equal to 120 will multiply to 80. Then again you can write, leave some space so that it will be easier to distinguish between chemistry, physics and economic books. So here I shall write once again. Here you can see rupees 60 is meant for one book of physics. So here I shall write one physics book cost rupees. Here you can write 60. Then you can write one physics book cost rupees 60. So here you can see each subject. Each subject means one subject. So here rupees 60 is meant for middle subject, that is physics. The cost of one book of physics is rupees 60. Therefore, how many number of physics books are there? 96. So here you can write 96 physics books cost equal to 96 equal to 60. You have got, again you can write here such that last subject, that is economics. So here you can see one book of economics cost rupees 40. So here you can write one economics book cost is how much? 40. Therefore, how many economic books are there? Here you can see the number of economic books are 120. So here you can write 120 economic books cost is 120 into 40. You will get. So here you can see the first subject, that is meant for chemistry, this one you will get. Second subject, that is physics, for physics total cost will be this one. And third subject, that is economics, total cost will be this one. The same thing, this term will be reflected in the form of matrix. So let us how you will determine here. Here you can see 120, 96 and 120 are like terms, must be grouped together respectively. Why like terms? Because here you can see total number. Here you can see total number. Here you can see total number. For chemistry books, total number is there. For physics book, total number, this one. For economics book, total number, this one. These are the number of books. That's why 120, 96 and 120 are like terms, might be grouped together. First of all, what will do? Matrix representation will be, here I shall write matrix representation will be 120, 96 and 120 respectively. 120, that is the total number of chemistry books. 96 is the total number of physics books. 120 here, the total number of economics books. These are the like terms. These like terms must be grouped together. So if you write these terms, first one here chemistry, this one first one chemistry, 120 chemistry,
96 physics, 120 economics. Irrespectively are there. So these numbers will be number of books. Since these are the number of books, will be grouped together. I shall represent these numbers in the matrix form like this. Respectively represent 105, 120 is given. Write here 120. After that you can see here 96 is there, right here 96. Here you can see 120 is there, right here 120. Opening of square bracket, I have done here. Thereafter I have written the total number of chemistry books, 120. Thereafter I have written the total number of physics book, 96. And at third position, I have written 120, that is total number of economics books. This is a matrix of order 1 cross 3. Why 1 cross 3 is there? Because here you can see the total number of rows is 1. Total number of rows here 1. And the total number of columns you can see. Column number 1, column number 2, and column number 3. The total number of columns here are 3, and total number of rows here is 1. This matrix will be of order 1 cross 3. Since here you can see the cost of one chemistry book is 80, then the cost of 120 chemistry books will be 120 into 80, it is there. Here also 96 is 60 is there. Here you can see 120 into 40 is there. Therefore, here I shall apply multiplication theorem on matrices. Therefore, I shall write here multiplication sign. Thereafter, I shall form another matrix. Do here opening of square bracket. Here closing of square bracket you can write here very well. Closing of square bracket, this one you can do here like this. Now here you can see, since here multiplication sign is there, here 120 total number. 120 here is total number of chemistry books. Here 96 is total number of physics books. Here 120 is total number of economic books. So here number, like terms are there. I have grouped together and written like this. So this is a matrix of order 1 cross 3. Because here the number, total number of rows is here 1. And total number of columns here you can see 1, 2, 3. 3 columns are there. Thereafter, I shall form two things are there here. Here you can see the total number. Here you can see total number are there. Another term is there. Cost. That is amount. So here you can see two terms are there. Two things are there. The total number are there. The total number with the help of total number of all books I have formed one matrix here. And here total amount is there. So with the help of amount I shall form another matrix. Both matrix will be multiplied together because here everywhere multiplication sign is there. That's why I put here multiplication sign. Another matrix I shall form with the help of amount, rupees. So here you can see multiplication sign is fixed here. So this, the first matrix here is of order 1 cross 3. So here the total number of columns in first matrix is 3. Multiplication sign is there. So when the multiplication among two matrices will be possible? When the total number of columns of first matrix will be equal to total number of rows of the second matrix. So here rows, number of rows will be 3 fixed here. Because here 3 is there, so here 3 I shall fix here. Here I shall form three rows. The first row I can write here, this one. 120 I have written here, 120. So here I shall write 80. This one, 120 respective element. 120 that it belong to chemistry. This is the number of chemistry books. This is the price of one chemistry book, that is 80. Here it is given here. This one I have taken. And second one you can see here 96, here 96, 96, 96 I have reflected here. This 60 is the price of one physics book. So here I write 60. And here you can see I have written here for the economics book. Total number of economics will be 120. I have reflected this one. And here you can see the price of one economics book here 40. So here I write 40. This one I can put here, this one. Or here you can see first row, second row, third row. This is a matrix of order 3. This one will be tallied together. And number of columns here is 1. They write here 1. This one you can write like this. Here multiplication sign is fixed here. Multiplication between first matrix and second matrix will be possible when the number of columns in the first matrix will be equal to the total number of rows in the second matrix. So here you can see in the first matrix, first column, second column, third column. In the first matrix, total number of columns is here 3. And second matrix, total number of rows, first row, second row, third row. So total number of rows here 3. That's why multiplication sign will be put here. So if you multiply respectively, multiplication, two matrices are there. If you multiply the two matrices together, 120 will multiply to 80, you will get this one, verified. And 96 will multiply to 60, you will get this one. And 120 will multiply to 40, this one, multiply to 40, you will get this one. So then you can write very well, equal to, form here, I shall write here equal to, multiply the two matrices, we will get this one. Here you can see, this 3 is the total number of columns of the first matrix. And this one 3 is the total number of rows of the second matrix. So these three will be clubbed together and will be eliminated. So we will get the output matrix of order 1 class 1. So here the order of the output matrix will be 1 class 1. So here write 1 class 1. Now form the element here. 120 will multiply to 80. So here you can write. Just write like this. 120 will multiply to 80. 120 multiply to 80. Leave some space. And 96 will multiply to 60. 96 will multiply to 60. And 120 will multiply to 40. So here 120 will multiply to 40. You have got here output matrix of order 1 cross 1. Do the operation here. Here you will get like this. You can write one wrong thing I have written here. Erase this one. 120 will multiply to 80, we will get this one. right here in bracket. Plus will be there. Don't write bracket. Once again, 120 will multiply to 80, will get this one. Plus will be there. And 96 will be multiplied to 60. This is 60. 96 will be multiplied to 60. Plus 120 will multiply to 40. This will be the output matrix, or order of this output matrix you can see here. This one you have got. The order of matrix will be 1 cross 1. Why? Because here you can see the total number of rows will be 1. Because multiply this one, add this one, multiply this one, add this one, multiply this one, add this one. So you will get only one row, only one column you will get. So that's why the order of the output matrix will be 1 cross 1. Do the operation here. You will get here. 00 you get. And 12 at 96 you will get. Plus 96 multiplied to 6 here. You will get here. 6 are 36. Remainder will be 3. And 6 and 9 are 54. 54 plus 3 will get here 7. 10 I shall add here, plus again I shall write 9600. Do the operation. This is a matrix of order 1 cross 1 you will get. Equal to. Add the things here. I shall add, going to add here, 96 plus 5760 plus 96. Things will be added together. You will get here 0, 6 and 6, 12. 6, 6, 12. 12 or 7. How much you will get? I think I have done mistakes here. Just check. 6 and 36. 3. 6 and 54. 357. This is written here. Or here we will get. This is 40. So here we will get only 48 00 will get. 00 will get. So add the things here. You will get, this one is 4800, right here 4800, this one you have got here, here you could just, 8 is 7, 15, 15 plus 6 you will write here 21, remainder will be 2, 2 plus 4 will get here 6, 6 or 9 you will get here 15, 15 plus 5 you will get here 20. The output here you will got here, that will be the matrix 20,160, 1 cross 1. This one you have got here. This amount you have got here. So hence, the answer will be, what answer you push? Find the total amount of the books of will receive from selling the books using matrix algebra. So here I have used here, this is the matrix algebra I have represented here. This is normal algebra. Normal mathematics, unitary methods I have applied here. And this is the matrix algebra. With the help of matrix algebra, I have got the answer here. So here the answer will be, here I shall answer, write here answer. Implied at Rees. Here you got 20,160. Answer will be here 20,160 will be the correct answer. This will be the correct answer. The solution of question number 20 in exercise 3.2 I have completed here. The correct answer you have got here, rupees 20,160. That will be the correct answer of question number 20 in exercise 3.2. Chapter 3, Matrix and CRT 12 Mathematics. Okay, guys.